What I'd like to see in the community is change, because we've been finding too many promises given to the El Dorado Park community.
They say something and if you vote for them, they change it after a certain time and they never keep to their promises.
I've seen guys going out, putting effort into the programs they have, but once they benefit out of the community, the youths, they leave them just stagnant, but not, no proper feedback, no positive feedback.
We lack a lot of skills development. We're limited to a few resources.
So I would be board councillor, and then I would like to change the current unemployment in El Dorado Park because I feel that creates a lot of crime.
I'm Councillor Peter Rafferty, current councillor of Ward 18, El Dorado Park.
My name is Laura Hatebe, the candidate for Ward 17.
Hi, my name is Lloyd Phillips. I am the council candidate for the Patriotic Alliance.
During my term as councillor for Ward 18, I have ensured at least 2,000 young people that received permanent work throughout this process. And this was predominantly from private companies that came through that we partnered with. Also, what I've done is we still focused on the revival of sports, arts and culture, which will ultimately mean that if you combine those two, the epidemic of drugs, alcohol abuse, the sense of hopelessness can be dealt with effectively.
Why the young people should vote for the ANC? Because of the programs that we have for young people. We have a lot of job opportunities for young people where we need to register in the Vulindlela Joseph, be in the database. And only doing that, you can go in any library where the ANC government has made sure young people can access free Wi-Fi in all our libraries to be able to register for this program. We have the TEPO 500,000 program that will be launching on the 21st in Cape Town. Well, a lot of companies that have partnered with their municipalities for young people to get opportunities to register and be part of that. Let's get our young people skilled, employed, to be better future leaders of tomorrow.
What we have seen previously is that the lack of these opportunities hitting grassroots. And besides that, our people on the ground are not familiar with mining tactics, how to mine these opportunities, how to take advantage and embrace these opportunities and make the most out of these opportunities. That is what I would bring if I were elected as councillor, to actually represent the people as opposed to representing the city.
In this new term, I'm standing in a different ward, Ward 17, and what we'll be doing is we're setting up a database that will be easily accessible for any company that's looking for young people or training opportunities that will be there, but also a platform for communication, be it through social media that will be linked to this website that will make it easier for any youngster to engage.
Our young people within our community is not really being educated around the importance of their vote. And we believe that their vote is their only voice.
I never registered.
Why?
I don't know. Just because I don't feel like voting. I would vote. And the reason why I would vote is to have a better place to live and better education.
The change that we seek only lies in our vote, does not lie in promises and leadership. Whatever we believe we want to achieve as a community, we just have to vote that way.
We might think that individually our voices don't count or that it's not going to make a difference, but I think that if you can count all the single votes that aren't voting, they add up to a large population. You cannot complain if you don't get what you want if you have not voted.